Welcome back to AJSpeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to multiply fractions, and we're going to use a technique called cross-canceling to help get to the most simplified version of the product as fast as possible. All right, let's start off with the example 5/6 times 3/10. All right, times 3/10. All right, if we look here, we have a 5 in the numerator and a 10 down here in this denominator. Well, they share a common factor of 5, so I can divide both of these numbers by 5. 5 divided by 5 is 1, and 10 divided by 5 is 2. When I look at these cross pair here, in the numerator I have a 3, and my denominator is 6. These two have a GCF of 3, so that means I can divide both of these by 3. Well, 3 divided by 3 is 1, and then 6 divided by 3 is 2. So now at this point, when I multiply across my numerators and across my denominators. 1 times 1 gives me 1, and then 2 times 2 gives me 4. So here I get to the product of 1/4 without having to do any simplification after I've done my multiplication. All right, let's move on to our next example. This time, let's multiply 2/7 times 3/4. All right, when I look at the 7 and the 3, my cross pair here, they're both prime numbers and they don't have any factors in common other than 1. And dividing these by 1 is not going to help us. So let's look at this other cross pair. I have a 2 and a 4. Well, both of those numbers are even. So that means I can divide both of these numbers by 2. And dividing by 2 is the same thing as taking half. So half of 2 leaves me with 1, and half of 4 leaves me with 2. And then I proceed with multiplying across numerators and denominators. Well, here I have 1 times 3 to give me 3, and then 7 times 2 to give me 14. So my product here is 3/14. All right, our next example, let's do 4/9 times 5/8. All right, let's look for a cross pair. I have a 9 and a 5. They do not have any factors in common. And here I have a 4 and an 8. Well, the GCF between 4 and 8 would be 4. So 4 divided by 4 is 1. And 8 divided by 4 is 2. Then I proceed by multiplying these numerators and then denominators. 1 times 5 leaves me with 5. And then 9 times 2 leaves me with 18. So here 5/18 is my product. And let's take a look at one more example. Let's do 2/3 times 4/5. Well, my cross pair, I have a 2 and a 5. Again, both of these numbers here are prime, so they only share a factor of 1. When I look at the 3 and the 4, again, the only factor they share is a 1. So I'm not going to be able to do any canceling, so I just multiply straight across. 2 times 4 to give me 8, and then 3 times 5 to give me 15. So the point I was trying to make here is that not every time you multiply fractions, you're not going to always have any cancellations. All right, this sums up this tutorial by AJSpeller.com. And as always, thank you for watching.